It is another glorious day here on Jurassic Sanctuary. And the residents of the island are absolutely flourishing. And they like to spend their day in many different ways. Whether it's going down to the watering hole to get a drink, foraging for insects on a log, spending time with those close to them, patrolling their territory, or grazing on the open plains. Out on these open grasslands, we see a mixed herd of very unique-looking herbivores. The herd is comprised of a few pachycephalosauruses, a couple of stygomolics, and some dracorexes. The leader of the herd is a female stygomolic named Stiggy. Although she is a bit smaller than the other members of the herd, but in what her size lacks, her fiery personality makes up for it. In 2010, many paleontologists have suggested that both Dracorex and Stygomolic might have actually been juvenile Pachycephalosaurus. This theory was proven to be correct when the scientists at Jurassic World tried to clone these two dinosaurs. The scientists noticed that the skulls of these cloned specimens started to change as they matured, until they eventually grew up to be pachycephalosauruses. Many people were still used to having Dracorex and Stygomolic as their own separate genus, and they have requested to have them as new attractions for Jurassic World. So the scientists decided to clone some pachycephalosauruses with a gene that caused their bodies to stop growing and changing once they have reached a certain age. Although these cloned specimens are all still technically pachycephalosauruses, the researchers here at Jurassic Sanctuary still use the names Dracorex and Stygomolic to avoid confusion. What makes these dinosaurs so unique are their dome-shaped skulls and sharp spikes on the back of their heads, which they used for intraspecific combat. As well as defending themselves against predators. Better luck next time, Blue. brachycephalosaurs can fend off attacks from small carnivores, the same can't be said for larger carnivores. This is an Albertosaurus, a medium-sized theropod dinosaur that is a relative of the T-Rex, but is a bit smaller and more agile. This female isn't alone, as she has brought her mate with her on the hunt. Knowing that she can't fight off two large predators at once, Stiggy leads her herd to safety. It seems the Albertosauruses have ran into a bit of trouble, as a Pentaceratops, who we shall call Zeus, has interrupted their hunt. Pentaceratops are large and aggressive ceratopsians that will charge at anything they perceive as a threat. And the mere sight of these large predators is making Zeus uneasy. And so he charges.
Thank you.
The male Albertosaurus watches as the light fades from his mate's eyes. With nothing he can do, the male leaves his deceased mate. The Albertosaurus wasn't the only one to have lost a loved one. As the herd gathers around the body of the Pachycephalosaurus, who has died from her injuries. The herd decides to leave, as the scent of the corpse will soon attract scavengers to the area. It doesn't matter if you're at the top or at the bottom of the food chain. Death will always be inevitable, and Mother Nature makes no exceptions.